I could come with you, he said. For a little while at least, if it would help.
It's such a long way.
Those dark lights in his eyes. Imagine following the curvature of the earth through day and night. She trusted what he told her in that little restaurant beside the Sile, that he preferred the truth, even if difficult. She believed that if she decided to keep the baby, it wouldn't be a problem for him. He had such a holistic view of the universe that he didn't have a proprietary bone in his body. They were all atoms of the universe derived from the same singularity. We all belong to each other, etc., etc. She was sure he would embrace the child as his own. She loved him for that. But it wasn't his decision. A true lawyer to the last, her father had left written instructions for Claire. He'd wanted to be cremated immediately to save on repatriation costs, even though they would have been covered by his insurance. He wanted no fuss, no ceremony. He'd also been very specific about what he wanted to happen to his ashes. Simple wishes, he called them. A handful spread here, a handful there. She wasn't looking forward to standing alone on that crag at Tokarahi where they'd once stood together, where her grandfather had held in sorrow, but she'd do what she had to do. Claire had trawled the internet for an urn that had a screw top rather than a sealed lid, but the online catalogue was bewildering. Did she want what remained of her father preserved in original Venetian-blown glass or in pietra cerizzo stone? Stainless steel or hand-cast brass? Or perhaps biodegradable from renewable paper produced in a sustainable manner or bamboo with a magnetic lid? Could she see him in a container that looked like a phallus or a gherkin or in one that looked like a chocolate box? In an imitation giant acorn in russet brown or moss green, or in a heart-shaped biodegradable cornstarch heart with a soft natural feel, or in sand gel, guaranteed to biodegrade within 3 months if buried, or within 3 days if immersed in water. By way of decoration, would she prefer sculpted motifs or accent bands or gold leaf decorations intricately hand-decorated by skilled artisans, or handmade paper flowers, or a solid gold bow, or perhaps just a bloody great sculpture of a horse or a lion or other personally meaningful statuette on top.